5-minute bios, short on time, long on info, with George Fritchie. Today, Mark Twain. Mark Twain, born Samuel Langhorne Clemens on November 30, 1835 in Florida, Missouri, and died on April 21, 1910 in Redding, Connecticut, is considered one of the most important American writers of the 19th century. Twain is best known for his humorous and perceptive short stories that vividly and entertainingly portray the life and customs of America. Mark Twain was born the sixth of seven children into a family of modest living conditions. His father, John Marshall Clemens, was a lawyer and trader, while his mother, Jane Lambton Clemens, came from a wealthy family. Twain's childhood was relatively carefree until his father died in 1847 and the family ran into financial difficulties. After the death of his father, Twain left school at the age of 12 to work in a printing shop and later left for the Mississippi River to work as a riverboat pilot. The experiences of these years left a lasting impression on Twain and later flowed into his literary works. Mark Twain began his writing career as a journalist, writing articles for various newspapers in the United States. During this time, he developed his distinctive writing style, which was characterized by humor, irony, and lively character drawings. Twain celebrated his first major success as a writer in 1865 with a humorous short story, The Celebrated Jumping Frog of Calaveras County. This success enabled him to undertake his first journeys to Europe and the Middle East, which he later worked into his humorous travelogues, The Innocents Abroad, 1869, and A Tramp Abroad, 1880. Mark Twain's most famous works are the novels The Adventures of Tom Sawyer, 1876, and The Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, 1884, both set in rural Missouri in the 19th century and considered milestones in American literature. Huckleberry Finn, in particular, is often regarded as one of the first modern novels and is valued for its realistic depiction of language, characters, and social conflicts. In addition to his humorous stories and novels, Twain also wrote numerous socially critical essays in which he dealt with issues of racial justice, gender equality, and political corruption. His dry wit found expression in quotes like, "It is better to keep your mouth closed and let people think you are a fool than to open it and remove all doubt." Despite his continued success as a writer, Twain's personal life was marred by financial difficulties and personal tragedy. Several of his children died early. Moreover, he invested his fortune in unsuccessful business projects. Mark Twain married Olivia Langdon in 1870, and the couple had four children altogether: Langdon, Susie, Clara, and Jean. Sadly, Langdon died in infancy, and Susie and Jean died in young adulthood, deeply saddening Twain and his wife. Olivia died in 1904, 6 years before Twain's own death, leaving him in deep mourning. Despite his personal losses and financial difficulties, Mark Twain continued to write until the end of his life. In his later years, he devoted himself increasingly to political and social issues and published, among other things, the satirical novel A Yankee at the Court of King Arthur, 1889, in which he confronted American society with the medieval world of the legendary King Arthur. Mark Twain died on April 21, 1910, at the age of 74, in Redding, Connecticut. His grave is in Woodlawn Cemetery in Elmira, New York, next to that of his wife and children. Mark Twain left a lasting impression on American literature with his distinctive style and humorous, keen observational skills. His novels and short stories offer important insights into 19th century life and culture in the United States. Twain was an avid advocate of honesty. In his own words, "If you tell the truth, you don't have to remember anything." Twain's works have influenced generations of writers, including Ernest Hemingway, F. Scott Fitzgerald, and William Faulkner. His stories have also often been filmed and have a firm place in the cultural memory of the United States and the world. So much for Mark Twain, and until the next episode of 5 Minutes.